If you've got an insurance question, you could talk to a dentist. But instead of filling you in on ways to save on your policies, he'd probably be too busy filling in that loose crown. Or you could talk to your local GEICO agent, who will use their expertise to polish up your policies, from home and auto to renters, motorcycle, boat, and RV too. So while, yes, your dentist can save your smile, your GEICO agent could save you money, which will make you use that smile a whole lot more. To find a GEICO agent near you, visit geico.com/local.
All right. We had some technical problems. I need to make sure we are up and live right now. Are we up and live right now? We had some technical difficulties. I don't appear that we are live. Okay. I know what's going on. All right. Let's get on up out of there. Let's get up. It's getting kind of personal around here. All right. Live. There we go. All right, we're live now. Okay, let's see if we can go and get this thing popping off again. Y'all can't see it. I'm feeling Sprinkle Man, but this is the countdown, the official countdown. The official countdown. I'm not hungry yet. Oh, it's about to go down. All right, we starting to stream. Oh, it's up. So,
throw up a fist of black power, cause all, throw up a fist of black power, cause all we want is freedom.
So we dropping signals now. I don't know what's going on.
Cause all we want is freedom. Throw up a fist of black power.
Get it. Let's get it. Cause all we want is freedom. All we want is freedom. We ain't asking for a lot.
Throw up a fist of black power, cause all we want is freedom. Throw up a fist of black power, cause all, throw up a fist of black power, cause all we want is freedom.
Ain't no more begging though.
What?
Oh, it wasn't supposed to transition like that. Let me change that transition. That's what's great about running the show. You get to go back and correct my mistakes.
Here we go.
Come on, bring it. Drink your water. Come on now, join the ritual. Come on. Come on. Come on. Drink your water. But first, take your breath and drink some water.
Take your breath.
Take your breath and
Come on, breathe, breathe.
Take your breath and drink some water. Take your breath. Drink, 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 drink. Or should I say, breathe, breathe, then drink.
Take a breath, take your breath.
Now, grab your glass for some water.
Grab your glass.
Lift your pitcher of that water.
Or a bottle.
Get that pitcher of that water.
Simply pour some water.
Drink, 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 drink.
Drink your
water. Or should I say, lift, pour, then drink. Now move your body and drink some water.
Move your body.
Move your body and drink some water.
Move your body.
Move your body and drink some water.
Bam.
Just move your body. Drink, 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 drink.
Drink your water.
Or should I say, move, move, then drink.
Move your body.
Move your body. Now raise your glass and toast your ancestors. Raise your glass and toast your ancestors. Raise your glass and toast your ancestors, fam. Just raise your glass. Drink, 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 drink.
Drink your water.
Or should I say, raise, toast, then drink. Take your breath and drink some water.
Take your breath.
Lift and pour yourself some water.
Pour.
Move your body, drink some water.
Move it.
Raise your glass and toast your ancestors. Breathe, lift, move, toast. But remember to stay healthy, remember the four pillars. Breathe, drink, eat, move. Drink half your weight in ounces.
Eat a culturally appropriate diet.
Behave. Take your breath.
Come on.
Lift and pour.
You can do it.
Move your body.
Come on, come on.
Toast your ancestors. Drink up.
Come on, drink it, drink it, drink it.
You can do it. You can do it. Come on, drink it.
Lift and drink it. Come on. Drink that healthy air.
Drink, 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 drink.
Drink your water.
Take your breath.
Take your breath. Take your breath.
Lift and pour.
Lift it.
Move your body.
Come on, come on.
Toast your ancestors.
Toast.
Drink, 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 drink. Drink your water. Drink, 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 drink.
Come on, come on.
Drink your water. Take your breath. Lift and pour.
Come on, pour it.
Move your body.
Come on.
Stay healthy, family. Come on.
Toast your ancestors. Drink, drink, drink,
drink.
Drink your water.
Drink, drink, drink.
That's not COVID.
Drink your water.
All right, family. Woo. Excuse me. That was... That's sort of my breakfast, because right now we are on the water part of the fast, but hey, I need to let you know you are now standing in the congregation of the mighty, the home of the stubborn minority. We go this way. The place where your hustle builds muscle. This is Giami Journey Media.
Why?
That skirt?
Mm-hmm.
No. Real life is Giami Journey. Are y'all still selling stuff today?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Y'all got to check my little thing. Gina got her little business popping off, so I need to go and publicize that. What is the name of your business?
Gina's Good Slime. It has a little...
It's called what?
Gina's Good Slime.
Gina's Good Slime? Okay. You say you don't have a website? You don't have a website?
No.
All right, we're going to get you a website. We're going to get Gina G a website.
We're going to get Gina G a website. But anyway, of course, you know it's a Heart of a Simple production. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. And we are on Ujima. We want to give all of the Ujima family members a round of applause. Come on, y'all can do better than that. Great job. Well, you know, this is a Heart of a Simple production all day, air day. Well, we strive to blow up your old paradigms. All right, family, all right. I just want to say great Ujima to you. I want to make sure that you know that every morning at 5:45 a.m., we are up and toasting those ancestors. It's 5:45 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. You can catch us on all of our platforms. We're streaming on our Facebook page. We're streaming on our YouTube pages. You know what I'm saying? Just look up Giami Journey and or GNJ.media. You know what I'm saying? Or go on and check out our podcast, which is the most beneficial for us, actually. You know what I'm saying? So, without any further ado. Don't want to do that. Without any further ado. Alright, cool. Alright, I just sent my daughter a text. I sent one of my daughters a text. I asked, I said, have you read Octavia Butler? She said, Kindred, Fledgling, The Parables, The Dawn series was weird but good. Two of the Wild Seed series. The third one lost me, I think. Alright, I got you. But yeah, right now I am exploring Octavia Butler and I am going through the Parable series and man, I'm enthralled. I am feeling each page turn. I am wanting to get to the end, but dreading for, the series to end and fearing how it may end. The craziest part about the whole journey through the book is that, like I posted on my timeline, I don't know whether it's fiction or prophecy. It's bringing up a lot of points that, I think we need to discuss as a tribe. I think it's going to be a series that is going to be a mandatory read for everybody in Giami, because it reflects the seriousness, or it shows some of the things that can happen with the seriousness of what we're trying to build. And I don't want nobody coming in here not knowing and being able to be broken real easily because of some little petty bullshit, because we haven't even got to the real part of the struggle for the struggle for what's ours. Literally. You know what I'm saying? For the struggle of what's ours. We haven't even scratched the surface of you know what I'm saying? Of what's to come. Alright, but anyway, we are heavy into, oh, by the way, just so that you know, BAM! You wasn't ready. Baynu Health, CMOS, we be going in, Baynu said he's going to be going in production real soon, so we're going to see about that, let you know how much, what the prices are, and be able to send you to a site, with a nice write-up on the health benefits of CMOS, and how you can get it, and support GNJ.media, you know what I'm saying, you know, because Baynu, out of all of our sponsors, Baynu keeps it real. He's breaking us off. You know what I'm saying? So, all right. Right now, we are continuing through Freedom Within Limits. We are on day 16. Now, I didn't know when I put this little book together that it had that much stuff. You know what I'm saying? Just with the, if we was to just keep it exactly at the 10-minute mark, we would be 160 minutes in to this little informational book. This, I don't, you know what I'm saying? I'm not one of those big long writers where, you know, like, for example, reading the parable of talents, right? That's a 13-hour read. I'm not that type of writer as of yet. You know, so who knows what it'll be. I haven't hit my 60s, nor I have never been 60. I have never been 70. So I don't know what may hit or what talent may surface as I continue on this journey. But anyway, we are on Freedom Within Limits. And if you look into the links that I, if you look at the write-up that I provided, that I provide for the show, I am providing links to where you can actually get the hard, because it just hit me that a lot of people that might be listening to Giami Journey don't necessarily like audiobooks and don't necessarily like digital books and may want to get their hands on the hard books. And I put that, I put where you could get it. I put my author's page up there so that you could get that. You know what I'm saying? So that, you know, if you feel that you, you know what I'm saying, you want to support Giami in that way and get your hands on the actual book, I put it up there, so you're going to get that. All right, so we're going to start with Freedom Within Limits. Anime, can you get everything set up for me, baby, please? So, while Anime is setting things up, I want to make sure that you know that every morning at 5:45 a.m., we are doing a toast, and we just wanted to make everything as regular as possible so that people can start setting a pattern, start building up their personal cycles, you know what I'm saying? And you'll bless Giami Journey to allow us to assist you to bring that value, to bring that value where we can help you start your ritual today. And want to make sure that people know that in order to participate with the ritual, you could just watch, but it's more beneficial to you as well as to our people if you participate. And what do you need to participate? Get your own glass. You know what I'm saying? We're going to have some glasses soon at Giami Journey that you could get. You know what I'm saying? We could find you some nice glasses, a nice glass maker. Get you a glass. Get you some fresh water. Get you a health drink. Right? Those are the core, because the thing we talk about here at Giami Journey, that if we are not able to take care of ourselves, how can we take care of others? And if we can't take care of ourselves, how can we really take care of our ancestors? Our body is more than a tool, but it is the part of us that is able to interact with this world, right? And we have to keep this in tip-top condition, you know what I'm saying, for as long as we can, all right? Because this is the tool in which our spirit works, our mind works, our emotions work, our intuition work. This is the tool, right, that is used to make all that stuff be able to be manifest and be able to be to share with others. You understand what I'm saying? To build. This is the major part. This is your interface with the actual world. All the other stuff is like software. You know what I'm saying? And this is like the actual laptop, the actual desktop, the actual Chromebook, the actual cell phone. That's what your body is, and you got to keep it up. And some of y'all take better care of your cell phones than you do of your body. Shame on you for that. But anyway, Anime, are you ready? Anime is ready. All right, cool. War horn. It is so funny watching the Phoenix blow the horn. I don't know how she makes the beak swell up like, but anyway. Can I get my thinking music, please? You're damn right. Thinking all the time. Can I get my timer? My timer is going. Let's get it. We got Haku by Hatim. That's the name of the chapter. Now, for those that don't know, Freedom Within Limits, the subtitle is Haku by Hatim. All right, but anyway. I have found many people that I coach are waiting for greatness to come and knock on their door. I hate being the person to tell them that will never happen. In order to live our dreams, we have to be willing to put ourselves in uncomfortable situations that bring the best out of us. We have to be willing to do the unconventional and blaze a trail that the rest of the world can look at in amazement. We have to be willing to step away from the herd and maybe put our lives at risk. We have to be brave enough to burn our bridges so that we can so that we can't retreat safely. Even put our backs against the wall and look fear directly in the eye. To be extraordinary, we have to do what Tony Robbins describes as massive action. Many of us may want to walk the approved path and hope to attain greatness, but we will only end up with the same things that everyone else is getting from walking that path. A middle of the road existence. In my studies, everyone that has done great things has had to learn to think and act differently from the society, from what society taught them. They had to go through a personal crucifixion. This was a time of great sacrifice and pain. They had to face the criticism and small-mindedness of everyone around them. This is part of the price, and more importantly, the test of greatness. To be extraordinary, we have to be willing to pay these fees. Believe me, they will come when and from whom you least expect it. What seems to freeze most of the people that I coach is that they don't want to be uncomfortable or even make others feel uncomfortable. How can you want to revolutionize your field, manifest your dreams, and create something new without shaking up the world? And yes, you will lose your confidence, which are nothing but illusions designed to keep you where you are in life. People will definitely be uncomfortable around you because your very success shakes the foundation of what they believe about you and forces them to look at themselves. Beware the status quo. This is a ghost that most people fear and will do everything to stay in its grip. And even worse, will do almost anything to keep you under its spell as well. So are you ready for greatness? Are you willing to burn the bridges to nowhere in your life? Are you willing to put your back against the wall and stare your fear directly in the eye? If so, I welcome you on your GMA journey. Here we go to haikus. Hedge funds are simple. Bet against your investment. Get paid as they fail. This is a haiku by Tim. Thank you, NPR, for the info. Support NPR fundraising drive. Okay, that's what I put out there for that day. I mourn my passing, leaving only what I know, hoping to help all. Here we go. Here's another one. Mine blooms like flower. My inner sun has risen, and the light feeds me. Next, programs come and go. It takes commitment to save our communities. Another proverb, we learn by questions. Questions like fire of mind that burn to the truth. Next, what do you expect? That is what you will receive. Look for what you want. What are you looking for in this life? The sad truth is that we usually find what it is we seek, although this could be viewed negatively. Through the lens of our training in this life,
This holiday season, we all wish for hope and healing. Children and families who spend their holidays at the hospital deserve a reason to believe in first steps, in giggles, high fives, and hugs. For 150 years, Children's National Hospital has provided world-class care and groundbreaking research. Please donate today to help patients and healthcare heroes this holiday season. Visit childrensnational.org/holiday. That's childrensnational.org/holiday.
Lauren Elena is coming to Washington, D.C. Come see Lauren Elena's Top of the World Tour live on February 24th at the Fillmore Silver Spring with special guest Spence Crandall. We would die by kissing heartbreak, no strings, Saturday night. Tickets are on sale now at LiveNation.com. Don't miss Lauren Elena at the Fillmore Silver Spring on February 24th. Get your tickets today.
Training into this life. When we view this fact from another angle, we empower ourselves. If it's true that we find what we look for and the world gives us what we expect, then be bold and look for what it is you want in life. Expect the best. Expect to be treated as royalty and expect to succeed. I know some of you skeptics are reading this and stating that this is not realistic, but I am issuing a challenge. I am betting that this view of the world is as real as yours. I have personally seen in my experience as a coach that many of the people that have a realistic view of the world get exactly what they expect. A big nothing. They expect disappointment and get it. They expect sadness and get it. They expect lies and get them. They expect accidents and get them. They expect cheating mates and get them. I can go on and on. What I am challenging you to do for a 30-day period, look for what you expect the best. What I am challenging you to do is for a 30-day period, look for and expect the best. I'm going to say that again because I read it wrong the first time. I want to make sure y'all get that. What I am challenging you to do for a 30-day period, look for and expect the best. Explore yourself and find what it is that you really want out of life and open your spirit, mind, and body to receive it. You have to take time to retrain your mind so that you can begin to see it. What have you got to lose? Many of us have already suffered heartbreak, calamity, disappointment, and etc. So what could you lose if you try to change your view of life and start expecting what you truly deserve? Now, the first thing we have to tame in ourselves is the beast of fear that has been instilled in us. Fear is a common thing that I was writing about in my blog. This fear assists us in seeing only the ugly and dangerous in life. It prevents us from changing to what it, hold on, it prevents us from changing to what we want to be and stops us from finding what we really are seeking. Better yet, it hides what we seek in a cloak of illusion that prevents us from seeing truly and correctly what is before us. In the self-mastery process, we use a lot of myths and have not read about one's hero who has not been confronted with this fear and the illusion it presented. Usually, the hero will be presented with a situation or a person that appeared to be horrible. But through them mastering themselves, they were able to see within the soul of this situation or person and get the lesson and power that they held. The prime example of this is the story of the Princess and the Frog or Beauty and the Beast type stories. Or bringing it into current times, we can use the story of hip-hop. When we look at the development of this culture, we see poor youth looking for escape from poverty. They could have given into what the environment and what the world dictated. But by changing their view, they were able to change how they were seeing their situation and change their expectation. From this, they were able to create things that were not there before. From materials that the rest of the world viewed as junk, cardboard, old turntables, broken mics, old paint, old clothes, etc. And created something that now influences the world. Another blog for another day, because hip-hop's true power has yet to be tapped into. Marcus Garvey says it best. What man has done, man can do. What is holding you back from changing your life? What is the major roadblock that is stopping you from changing your view? How you doing? Changing your view of this world and changing your expectations. Be bold and change what you see. Be brave and change what you expect. And watch your life change as well. For years I've been put, or better yet, allowed myself to be put into a situation where I'll be forced to try to get blood from a turnip. In other words, teach people who don't want what I have to offer. Many of the young people that I work with are at a point where they have to be introduced to spirituality outside of their familiar surroundings. Unfortunately, the group that I was working with were locked up. They can't leave the pods they are in. So I find that the majority are not receptive to much of anything. The minority that are willing to learn are often overpowered and outgunned by the ignorant. I've often found in my experiences that when we move outside of our comfort zones, something inside of us opens up. It seems we hear better. We drop our shields and become receptive. I get that. I guess that's why the traditional rites of passage, the people undergoing the initiation were removed from the community and put in an uncomfortable situation. This opened them up for the lessons to come. This gives us space and time to change internally. When you add different activities that are outside of what we thought was possible, we create a change. For example, in a vision quest, an individual will be led out by themselves and left. First, they are removed from what they know. Next, they have to challenge themselves to stay wherever they are, left alone, without food and sometimes water. Unusual circumstances create unusual opportunities for growth. There are thousands of similar activities that we can plug into to change ourselves as well as help people change. But if we keep doing what we've been doing, we can only get what we have been getting. To expect something else is, as they say, insane. I had to decide not to be insane anymore. My biggest pain was that it was not necessarily the kids that I work with, but the system that they are involved in. It's almost like the kids feed off the system, and the system feeds off the kids, forming a feedback loop that produces unhealthiness. To make changes, we have to remove the kids or the system so that the changes can be made. How many of us are caught in an unhealthy feedback loop in our life? What does it take for us to change? Who can we blame for our situation? What holds us stuck in these broke systems that no longer work or never worked? I think we hide behind these systems because they give us the illusion of safety and stability. I was pursuing an illusion. Are you? All right, so I'm going to stop right there. And that last question, let's go on. A statement and a question. I was pursuing an illusion. Are you? You know what I'm saying? I want that to stick. So I'm going to read that last paragraph. How many of us are caught in an unhealthy feedback loop in our life? Those that don't know what a feedback loop is, look it up. Look for a picture. Look for a video so that you can get it, so that you can hear it in a way or see it in a way that it is understandable, because many of us are caught up in these feedback loops, unhealthy feedback loop. What does it take for us to change? What does it take for you to change? Who can we blame for our situation? Is there anybody to blame for the situation? What holds us stuck in these broke systems that no longer work or never worked? I think we hide behind these systems because they give us an illusion of safety and stability. An illusion of safety and stability. I was pursuing an illusion. Are you? All right, family, anime, if you would, baby, please. That's right, family. We are bringing it home. I need my music. I'm thinking all the time, and as we say in GMA, class dismissed. Now get the hell up out my classroom. All right, because I want y'all to think about that. So we're moving on. We're still in the chapter of Haku by Hatim. It's not that long. Oh, my fault. It's a little bit longer than I thought. Okay. We're going to keep it popping off. Keep it popping off, exploring that whole self-mastery concept. All right, we're going to move into our toast, okay? We're going to move into our toast. For those who don't know, we toast every morning at 5:45 a.m. We call out the ancestors' names. For those of you that want to add your ancestors to the list, it's a very, very simple process for you to do so. All you have to do, is go to gnj.media, go straight to gnj.media, get up right now, go to gnj.media, and below the video, you'll see a little rectangle box, long rectangle box that says email address. You type your email address in and click follow, and you will be added to our list. And Okay, cool. I'm okay. You'll be added to our list. And once you are added to our list, right? You'll be able to correspond with us. We will send you an email. You send us an email. Oh, man, I forgot to send this out on Telegram. I wanted to send this out on the Telegram. I'm trying to learn how to use it. But, you know, but the one thing, one good thing about the podcast, once I post it up, unlike some of the videos, the link will stay. It's like, I guess it's like a permalink where you will be able to get the get it all the time. So, and once you are corresponding with us, you'll be able to add your ancestors to the list. You got to be in correspondence with us. Of course, you could take the old method and go and inbox us on one of our social media platforms. But the best way to get with us is to move.
Mommy made us miss the bus.
The best way, that sounds like a personal problem. If I'm going to the same place, I couldn't wait till after I got done with my show. All right, family, so it's real life here, Jeremy Journey all the time. So, you can add your ancestors to the list. Very simple process. All right, just go on and do it. Best way to do it is to join our email list, right? And like I said, correspond with us on the email list. For those of you that are on Telegram, if you want to share your Telegram name, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm sending out when we go live on Telegram too, to those that might be interested. And you know, like I said, and if you don't do nothing but want to help us by sharing that we are up, sharing our rebroadcast, I would greatly appreciate it. I would appreciate all the tribe members doing that, because we got to start spreading the word. Right now, we are on, some of us are on a fast. We are on our winter fast. And I want to make sure y'all heard what I said. I said our winter fast. WINNER fast. Our winter season fast, right? Because we're moving into the winter, and we want to go into the winter as winners, right? We want to move into this new year as winners. And that's what we're going to do. So right now in my fast, on our fast, we're doing a fast. And I'm only able to do water today. Tomorrow will be not, you know, I'm going to be toasting and stuff. But the glass is going to be empty, because tomorrow is an empty day. We call that day a power day, right? That's a power day, because we fast in the form of a pyramid. So all the energy is building up towards that day, and whatever I want to direct that energy to, you know what I'm saying, ancestors, it'll be directed towards that. And I have a very specific purpose of why I'm fasting. So I'm going to be shooting that energy out. But anyway, we're going to go lift up our glass to the creator, by whatever name you choose to call that creator. We lift that creator up high, and we salute that creator. And we say the word of power, at least the word of power here. We use the term Ashe. You can use whatever term you want. We say Ashe. Now, family, we move to our ancestors, and y'all know we toast them. I've said it four times already, y'all. We toast them every day. We read the names out loud, and you can feel free to add your ancestors to the list, right? So we lift up our glass, and we say, Ashe. Now, what we here to toast right now, we are on the moment of Ujima. I ask each and every last one of you, open up your reticular formation, get out there, seek Ujima. Seek it out, because it's a very, very, all the principles are powerful, but they are especially powerful on their time, right? The time, their day. This is Ujima. I want you to be out there. I want you to work with it. I want you to build with it. I want you to do what it is you can with it. I want you to share it in your conversation. I want you to use it in a business proposal. I want you to use it in a presentation. I want you to share it with somebody younger than you. I want you to share it with somebody older than you, right? We got to start using our culture. We got to start talking about our culture. I mean, there's no other way around it, family. And some people are going to be made to feel uncomfortable. Did you hear what I just got done reading? Did you hear some of that Giami, some of those Giami thoughts, right? So we lift up our glass. We salute the moment that we are in. For those that don't know, Ujima means collective work and responsibility. Righteousness is the meiotic principle of the day. Respect is the M7, what we teach the young people. Blue is the color, and you can support Giami Journey. And get yourself a nice shirt as well. You go to gnj.media. Go to gnj.media, or better yet, go to merch.gnj.media. Either way, we'll get you there. We're going to have some specific links over this break that I'm working on to get you, so that, you know, you'll be able to put dt.gnj.media or dailytoast.gnj.media and be able to take to the merchandise, put day name or day born, and be able to go to GNJ and be able to go to dayborn shirt.gnj.media or whatever. I'm gonna set it up. It's gonna be simple, and you're gonna be able to go, and you're gonna be able to get your Dayborn shirt. You're gonna be able to get, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna set it up nicely for you, okay? Or better yet, I might be for those, matter of fact, I think this is how I'm gonna do it. For those that want their Dayborn shirts, I'm gonna put Emoji Toast and Emoji Toast dot gnj.media, Coogee Toast dot, you know what I'm saying? Put it in there just like that, so that all you got to do is type in the day name, .gnj.media or /, you know what I'm saying, or /, however I do it. I'm going to put it in there so it's easy enough for you to get there, and you're going to support us by getting your shirts, all right? So we continue our toast. We lift up our glass. We move from the color to the hermetic principle. The hermetic principle is vibration. Male name for the day is Kwaku. Female name is Akua. We lift up our glass and we salute. The power of this moment. We understand the power of the moment. We have to use the moment. We got to use our culture in the moment, right? Because it's in the moment that we are able to express our culture, right? So we lift up our glass and we salute and we say Ashe. Last but not least, I pick up my mythic object. We got our phoenix egg, right? And we lift up our glass and we toast. We call out our children, our children's children, onto infinity, and we say, Ashe, Ashe, Ashe. Family, I wish you peace, power, joy, and 100 years. I lift up my glass. Let me go and do my breakfast. This is my breakfast. I'm sorry. Where is my manners? Let me put on something so y'all can cruise out of here too. There we go. We're going to do a little bit of Rashawn this morning. This is the Black Airbenders, which is composed of Storm 9000, and Brother Eddie Bear. So y'all going to check it out. Gina.
Okay.
I want to show you how to stop the, so I already stopped the stream, but I haven't stopped the podcast. So you go over here and you're going to click that red thing up there and stop it.
In the U.S. Army, you can make a choice to make your mark. With over 150 fields to choose from, join forces with us and take on anything.
Hi, my name is Joe, and I'm a home decor overspender.
Hi, Joe!
I made a breakthrough. I found HomeSense. It's unreal. So many brand name sofas. I bought one.
Oh, wow, really?
It's okay. The price is so low. Lighting, unexpected. Rugs, handcrafted. Wall art, eclectic. I go back like every week. No, it's always different. New unique decor, same great savings. Every time you go.
Field trip!
HomeSense. Standout pieces, outstanding prices.
Check 1, 2, check 1, 2. Check 1, 2 when the place to be. Alright, let's do that countdown. We are at 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Check the mic.
1, 2.
The 6 yard train comes through. Quicker than a Pentium data. For the next millennium, spirit informs. No conforms to the norms. Dropping bombs. I let it, said it, meant it. Here to represent it. Some live off the labels of the old school. Mold you, and that's the trend. What I tend to see, the new jack ain't new. In fact, just bitten pieces of debris. Recycling fragments of rubble. Rubble from a somewhat familiar voice. And so many MC and so whole little choice. This won't make me popular. Dropping the lyrics. That appeal and flock to ya, yeah. I yourself, I'm just as accurate as Doppler. I'm rocking ya, spiritual sip and sopping my fly your delve and it goes, hey y'all, y'all. I'm that spook who sat by the door waiting for the big score. While you're trying to get yours from the capitalist whore. And the red, white, and blue halter stacks and minis. She shimmies, you follow, you swallow. Losers, non-producers, consumers, consume. Propaganda's got me fuming, my people are doomed. Power to the people, power to the seekers. Instead, we're reduced to amps and speakers. $200 sneakers, acquisitions of loot, designer suits. Benz and Lexus, battle with sexes, sport utility trucks and such. We're slaves to a quick buck. We run amok. How far can we run when we're stuck? The race is won by wisdom, not muscle. Still, we all struggle. Should be excused the hustle for instant gratification, perpetuation of culture mutilation. Y'all, 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 hey. Instead, we have a love affair with dying. Getting drunk till we fold and dough till we blowed. Does the superficial high suffice for the lows? No time for idle. Introspection and life lessons are everyone's Quran, Torah, Bible. Gluttonous eats, defeats the true purpose of eats. The temple falls off from foreign chemicals, toxins, and meats. You call food enriched when it's stripped of nutrients and bleach. I'm not meant to be reached when flesh tone band-aids are peached. Every native slash European contract was breached. What will Ebonics do for the disenfranchised? Mumia gets no justice cause Mumia is despised. Reverse discrimination versus racism will never be tied. English, the bastard language of the not-so-civilized. The gift of spliced tongues is what the Western language gives. So isn't broken English like a double negative, yo? Yo, hey.
Hey, yo!
Hey, yo, hey, yo, hey, yo, hey.
Hey, yo, hey, yo, hey, yo.
All right. I think it's time. Let's get it.
Oh, it's time to get
ready. Oh, that's one of those hot Tim jams. Let's get it.
Shots out. Here we go.
Drink your water.
Come on.
Drink your water, but first, take your breath and drink some water.
Take your breath and drink some water.
Take it.
Drink. Or should I say, breathe, then drink.
Grab your glass for some water.
Lift your pitcher of that water.
Or a bottle.
Get that pitcher of that water.
Simply pour some water.
Drink.
Drink your
water. Or should
water.
I say, lift, pour, then drink. Now move your body and drink some water. Bam.
Just move your body.
Drink.
Drink your water.
Or should I say, move, then drink.
Move your body.
Now raise your glass and toast your ancestors, fam.
Just raise your glass.
Drink.
Drink your
water.
Or should
I say, raise, toast, then drink.
Take your breath and drink some water.
Take your breath.
Lift and pour yourself some water.
Move your body, drink some water.
Move it.
Raise your glass and toast your ancestors. Breathe, lift, move, toast. But remember to stay healthy. Remember the four pillars. Breathe, drink, eat, move. Drink half your weight in ounces.
Eat a culturally appropriate diet.
Behave.
Take your breath.
Come on.
Lift and pour.
You can do it.
Move your body.
Come on. Toast your ancestors. Drink up.
Come on. Drink it. Come on.
You can do it. Come on. Drink it.
Lift and drink it. Come on. Drink that healthy air.
Drink.
Drink your water.
Take your breath. Lift and pour.
Lift it.
Move your body.
Come on.
Toast your ancestors.
Toast.
Drink.
Drink your water.
Drink.
Come on.
Drink your water. Take your breath.
Lift and pour.
Come on, pour it. Move your body.
Come on.
Toast your ancestors.
Drink.
What?
Drink your water.
Drink.
Drink your water.
Family. Once again, y'all caught me slipping. I did not even send out the email. So I'm trying to, let's go with self-mastery, freedom within limits. All right, cool. I did not send out the email, and I am presently doing that as we speak. I am sending out the email with the email address to all those who are waiting for the email from the old man, and it is out. Give yourself a round of applause for that, Tim. You did it. You see, you did your, what you're supposed to do. You nimcompoop. Oh, you nimcompoop. But anyway, family. I want to welcome y'all. Of course, y'all know this. Hopefully, you know this. I haven't drunk. I'm not drinking water today. I'm not eating today. I'm at that high point. Right, and I was trying to stay away. I was going to stay home, but I got several different things that I have to do. I mean, the universe, man plans, God plans. You know what I'm saying? So it's a lot of stuff popping off, and I forgot that we had a show that moved. Blunt Talk moved to Ujima Nights. And also, we have warrior training on Ujima Nights. So, I can't very well stay home. So, I'm moving slow. I'm at the apex. So this is when stuff, during those fasts, those 21-day fasts, you know what I'm saying? Or this Ngozi Cyber Challenge, let's just say that. We got 7 days right now. I'm on the principle of Ujima. Fast for Ujima. Also, I'm fasting for the reason, and hopefully the energy is going to where it needs to be. Sending shots out. They know who I'm talking about. Sending out that energy for their wellness. But anyway, you know, we are what we are today. Of course, you know, it's nothing like being in the congregation of the mighty. In the home of the stubborn minority, in a place where your hustle builds muscle, this is Giami Journey Media. I am your host, Brother Hot Tim. And of course, you know that today is Ujima. So we want to give all the Ujima babies a round of applause. Clap it up for those Ujima babies. Clap it up for those Ujima babies. It appears my mic is a little bit too loud on my stream. So, check one, check two. I don't want it to peak all the time in the red. It's going crazy. There we go. That might be a little bit better for you on your ears. Check one, check two. All right, on Spreaker, we should be cool. I'm assuming. I'm going to turn it down just a little bit. Check one, check two. Check one, check two. Let's turn up. Check one, check two. I like to turn red every now and then. But I don't like it to stay in the red. Don't want to blast out my people with those sensitive earbuds. But anyway, we'll give up a round of applause for all those. Ujima born. Come on now, once again. That's right. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up. Give it up. Yeah. Give it up. Give it up. All right. Letting you know that, of course, you know that this is a Heart of a Symbol production all day, every day. Speaking of Sim, I had a dream about one of my elders last night. I'll have to give him a call. But anyway, and of course you know that this is, we strive to blow up your old paradigms. Just so that we won't miss it. Bam!
Fall is a season of gathering that brings us together with warmth and color. So whether it's a birthday, anniversary, or a special event, celebrate your friends and family with a gorgeous bouquet from 1-800-Flowers.com. 1-800-Flowers makes it easy to find your reason and brighten someone's day with exclusive offers and great values on bouquets and arrangements. To order today, visit 1-800-Flowers.com/tune in. That's 1-800-Flowers.com/tune in.
There you go. There you go. That CMOC, that's what I was supposed to work on last night. All right, so I had a couple of projects I was working on, so I wanted to make sure I got it so that y'all could order this. We're going to make it so that you could order this over the interwebs and support Giami Journey. I'm going to make it affordable. You know what I'm saying? Because when you, Bay New Health is one of our sponsors. I have to go and figure some stuff out. But, we will make it possible so that you could be able to go straight to Bay New Health. You know what I'm saying? Bainu Health and be able to check out what we got. We are going to be moving through Freedom Within Limits, written by myself, getting all my stuff down. So we're going to go through this real quick. And then we'll move, you know, then we go do whatever next we have to do. I'm kind of unbalanced right now. I don't know what's going on. I do. You know what I'm saying? Like the water, no water, no, you know, boom. So it is what it is. So we're going to make it through the day. But, like I said, those, we will be, I'm working on, I mean, several projects I'm working on. One of them is the Nguza Saba Challenge calendar or notebook, because this is an important part of our tribal lore, you know, and how you do it. You know what I'm saying? Making sure people are not hurting themselves when they are putting themselves through these type of processes, right? You know what I'm saying? So, it is what it is. So, we're going to get into Freedom Within Limits. So, anime, baby, if you could, please. Could you please? I just like to... I still don't know how she get her beak to fill up, but hey, it is what it is. And can I have my theme music, please? I'm thinking all the time. I can't help it. My mind is like a flower in bloom. But hey, here we go. We're about to get it started. Let me turn on the timer so that I can let myself know that when I'm going over time. All right. So here we go. Here's the haiku. Could the words you speak be the proverbial straw that breaks someone's back? Haiku by Haiku. Here go another one. I swim to what I thought was the depths of my soul, only found tip. Here's another one. We learn by questions. Questions like fire of mind that burns to the truth. Ooh. When did we stop asking questions? I have noticed during my self-mastery coaching sessions that I don't get a lot of questions. I also noticed a drop in questions in some of the lectures that I attend as well. What happened to the desire to know more than was revealed? Have we surrendered to our training and now just accept what we are told? I remember when I was younger, I used to get in trouble and embarrassed for asking questions. I was made to feel stupid for asking, but I did not care and still asked questions. Questions are what we use to sharpen our minds. In junior high, I learned about basic questions that I feel some of us need to dust off and to begin to use again. Who, what, where, when, why, and how? While talking to myself, as I was writing this blog, my grandfather overheard what my subject was, and he said, "Wow, listen, I don't know if you're..." So when I wrote this particular blog, my grandfather was sitting there with me. Wow. I remember I used to come to my mom's house because she would have to leave early for work. And me and Clee would have to come over here and sit with him until he got picked up, because I worked around the corner. So I would be able to come here and go from here and go to the school or wherever I was going. And my grandfather would be here. Wow. While talking to myself, I was writing this blog. My grandfather overheard what my subject was, and he stated, "We stop asking questions because the answer usually did not benefit us. By asking questions about injustice, you would put yourself and your family at jeopardy and could lose your position and, in some cases, your life." My grandfather is over 80, and he came up in a different time, but it is strange that some of the ideas that he was raised under still affect my generation. my children and grandchildren still to this day. In order to improve our lives and the lives of those around us, we need to learn the art and science of asking questions. We need to overcome the fear of challenging those in power by using the power of our minds to ask the basic questions. You may be looked at as a troublemaker, as an outcast, and etc., but you will be in good company. History is full of individuals who ask questions. To blindly follow and do what is commanded of you by anyone or anything, to me, is foolishness. Ask questions to keep your sword, mind, sharpened, and clean. Use your sword to protect those around you by asking the questions that they may fear to ask. Most importantly, remember, not only ask questions of others, but ask yourself questions. This is where the major work is done in our process. You must be willing to not only direct questions at the world, but you must, and I stress, must question yourself. This forces you to grow. This forces you to clean out the closet of your personal life. This helps you deal with addictions and habits that no longer serve you. Questions empower you, but if you only direct those outward, you become blind to your own failings. You become the bothersome questioner that inhibits his her own growth as well as others. By clogging up the process with useless questions that are designed to make you look intelligent rather than opening discussions so that your genuine knowledge can be shared. Question to ask yourself today. Who are you? What are you doing with your life? Where are you going in this life? When will you make the necessary changes? Why did you choose this place and time to be born? How will you accomplish your purpose? Co-authored by Cleveland Brown I. That's my grandfather. Co-authored by Cleveland Brown. The first. Well, I don't know if it would be the first, but I had to put that on it so I would remember that it wasn't Young Cleve. It's co-authored by Cleveland Brown. Wow. I heard baby cry. This is a haiku. I heard baby cry. I was compelled to action. Crying moves spirits. Stop blocking blessings. Stop standing in your own way. Move, fool, and let God. Let's stop blocking our blessings. Let's stop standing in our own way. Take some time today to search your heart and ask yourself the question that will lead you to how you are blocking your blessings. Let's search out our personal foolishness and get out the way and let the creative force move through us and for us. I cannot help but to stress the importance of monitoring our thoughts. Those that are on the journey of self-mastery need to begin to track where our minds go. A thought diary. This is a major block. I will even say the main foolishness that stops the flow of blessings in our lives. So get your mind right. And get the fuck out the way. Here we go. Another haiku. Our currency is not real, not backed by products, so it has to fail. Then we got separation from, initiation into, transformation now. I was thinking about the term rites of passage, and I've come to the conclusion that the title is wrong for the work that I am doing. Rites of passage is a term that was developed from a worldview that was shaped through anthropology. This is a science that strives to look at human activity from an outside perspective. When I look at something from an objective view, I can never truly get out of the process what is meant. Truly, when we look at what people were doing in this process we have mislabeled as rites of passage, we see that they were transmitting information that promoted the growth of the society that it came from. We have a process that is involved with two things. First, I am introducing you to the roles and responsibilities of the new position you will be taking in this society. On a deeper level, I was introducing you to a new part of yourself that was unknown to you. I label this the self-mastery process. Although most societies use the overall process to maintain the status quo, for some of the participants, a new way of seeing the world was unleashed. The participants will be introduced to the myths and rituals that will plug them into a power that will transcend this reality and send them on a lifetime journey to change the society. from what it is to the ideal developed in the legends and myths. These few individuals would, in a sense, become the archetype of the society and begin a quest to bring new life information to the group that will force growth and expand the worldview of the group or society. By introducing the new information, these individuals will end up going through the trials of ancient archetypes and through their suffering elevate the society to a new level. This is a process of self-discovery and mastery. Here's a haiku. Ailments that were dead now hunt and threaten cities. Who released these plagues? Damn. I don't know if y'all heard that one. Let me say that one again for you. Ailments that were dead now hunt and threaten cities. Who released these plagues? I just received a letter from my son's school warning me about whooping cough. I was watching the news and heard words like polio and measles. The word on the street is that bed bugs are running in New York City and may become the state mascot. I thought these ailments and critters were dead and gone. How did they come back on the scene? Think about this with me, please. Bed bugs have not been an issue in the U.S. since WW2, for those that are young in World War II. All of a sudden, they are a major issue. Whooping cough was a childhood disease that was all but eradicated. As a matter of fact, I have never seen anyone in my life with it. Now I have to worry about my child contracting it. The key word here is worry. Has anyone noticed that worry seems to be spreading like a virus? If you're not worried about terrorists, then worry about your kids. If not kids, worry about the economy. If not the economy, then worry about the bugs and the attacks in the city. Worry leads us down a path of fear, and fear makes it easy for people to be manipulated. I am not a big conspiracy buff, but all these things.
Grand Canyon University, a Christian university, is one of the largest and fastest growing universities in the country, offering over 200 engaging programs online. GCU invests in high demand areas such as nursing, teaching, and the sciences. Students engage with faculty who become partners in your success. GCU's online students received over $100 million in scholarships in 2020. Visit gcu.edu/myoffer to see the scholarships you qualify for.
The holidays are here, and this year, there's no better way to share the magic of the season than with a festive bouquet from 1-800-Flowers.com. 1-800-Flowers has holiday bouquets guaranteed to make everyone on your list smile. Right now, you can get 24 holiday light roses for just $39.99. Send a Merry Christmas with 1-800-Flowers. To get 24 holiday light roses for just $39.99, visit 1-800-Flowers.com/tune in. That's 1-800-Flowers.com/tune in.
Things happening at the same time makes me wonder, could some type of manipulation be going on? People are becoming so fearful that they will give up everything to feel safe, including their freedom. If you don't believe, look at the airport security. Free feels anyone. Those that have never been to the airport, those that have been to the airport know what I mean. So if you don't believe, look at the airport security. Free feels anyone. What is sad about this is that no one, and I mean no one, can guarantee your safety on this planet. The best you can do is the best you can do. I do the best that I can and leave the worry and fear where they are. I refuse to be manipulated by fear and plagued by worry. They produce nothing, but they leech my ashe, life force, make my mind weak, and help me become sick physically. Today on our journey, let's free ourselves of useless worries and move toward thought out actions. Let's release fear and embrace love. Let's use these challenging times to forge ourselves into the sheroes or heroes and legends that our great grandchildren will sing about. So crush a bed bug for me. All right. So I'm gonna end this one. Giami Journey welcomes all new readers. Let's grow together. So we're gonna move to the next page, and we are. I think we will finish a haiku by Tim tomorrow. As we move back to water, that was very entertaining, brother Hatim. Give yourself a round of applause. That was some good. Did some good writing, bruh. I'm impressed. Let the worry go. Now you notice when I wrote this, the priming of where we are now was going on. The priming for where we are now was going on. Now, I also want to state for GIAMI members, especially those of you over 16, we have some new required reading, and I know some of y'all be like, ah! But family, you are going to have to crack open the parable series by Octavia Butler. You have to crack open that. You have to read it. We have to read it. We have to have that as required reading because I want people to understand the seriousness of where we could be going. You know what I'm saying? I want you to understand the seriousness and the things that you may go through. And I want you to understand what it means when we sit up here, Jeremy, and talk about sacrifice because it's not cute. You know what I'm saying? It's, I mean, the words sound fly to be able to say that, but when you really think about some of the stuff that you may have to sacrifice to do what we're talking about, I just want to be as honest and open with people and give people the best examples that I can. Because I want y'all to understand that where this world could be heading and where we are striving to position ourselves in the world, how it's going to compromise many of us. How it's going to kill many of us. But if we stay true to what it is we are and who we are, we will win. As Mama Margarita say, shouts out to Mama Margarita. Give a round of applause because that's her point. She always say, we will win. We will win. We will win. Shouts out to Mama Margarita. And also in this dry libations, I got two specials that I need to throw out, Brother Kwesi, and also I want to throw out some extra energy for for Elder Tony and Elder Aziza. You know what I'm saying? For those that don't know, you know what I'm saying? You got to do your own research, but I want to send them some special energy. But anyway, hold on before we get into that. Anime, if you would, baby, please. How you do your face like I just... I'm sorry. Can I have my theme music? I'm thinking all the damn time. That's right. And as we say in GIAMI, class dismissed. Now get the hell up out of my classroom. All right. So, we are about to do our toast. Now, for those that don't know, we toast every morning at 5:45 a.m. That's 5:45 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. You catch us all around the world. Just time yourself, right? You just come on in and you can toast with us. Just go, you can listen to it on Spreaker, on our channel, GIAMI Journey Show, G&J. You know what I'm saying? I could throw up the link, but those of you on speaker, you already know. You could also, if you want to see the video, go to gnj.media at 5:45 a.m. or to any of our other social media networks. Now, this show, which is the Ujima Toast, or this is the Moment Toast, so each day we have the Daily Toast where we uplift the ancestors, and then later on, we do the toast for that particular principle. Today we are on Ujima, right? Once again, giving the Ujima babies a round of applause. You know what I'm saying? But for those of you that want to catch that, feel free at 5:45 a.m. Come on in, grab your glass, grab your water, grab your health drink, and make yourself at home. You know what I'm saying? Join the ritual. Help us build it up. Help us build up the energy around what we're doing. From there, You can add your ancestors to the list by going to the best way is to go to gnj.media, and at the bottom of the screen, if you go to the bottom of the screen, you'll see a place where you can enter your email address. Enter your email address, click follow. Now, once you start following us, you will be able to interact with us. Now, what does that mean? When I send you out the daily email to let you know when we're doing our show or to inform you about something, you know, sometime, you know, maybe the most will possibly be 3 emails in a day. You know what I'm saying? It depends on, like I said, if I have some special treats for some of the people, like when I get done putting together the books, you know, I will send out an email to the supporters as far as them being able to get the audio of my books and stuff like that, you know, because it'll be in there for free and I'll send it out to them. But anyway, or there's a special message or something that we have created or something that, you know, we want to invite you to, we send out the email to our list. But you'll be able to interact with us through that email. Once you start getting the emails, you better look at it and be like, hey, I'm going to click return, and you will be able to email us directly, right? And that's exactly what we want you to do. We want you to interact with us at Giami Journey Media, right? Also, while I'm thinking about it, I'm glad you brought that up. I haven't hit my Telegram group. Let's hit up the Telegram group and let them know that we own here, you know, and... oh, goodness. Okay. I need to go... Excuse me for another second, family. I want to make sure that we get this. There they go. We'll make sure we get them together so they could come join us. Boom. Send it out. There we go. Freedom Within Limits, number 17. I could also send them the gift out. Let me send that gift out there, too. Okay, there you go. I wait. Oh, there you go. I downloads. I might need to start moving some downloads. And then on top of that, you know, I come. Yes, we are. Join the tribe. There we go. All right, so, you know, So part of the issue for us, right? Part of the issue, you can reach us on all of our social media platforms, but the best way is that email interaction. We want to have some conversations with you. I check the emails periodically. You know what I'm saying? And like I said, also, but the most important part of that is that you can send us your ancestor list. Because some of y'all got a lot of ancestors now. All right? So, we got to be mindful of other people and their ancestors. We want to leave space for everybody. So, you know, be mindful of how many people you send in. All right? Please. Because remember, it's other people on the list. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, don't make it over, let's say, between 5 and 10. All right? Now, also, what we will have going out as well is we have what we call our tribal token. You know what I'm saying? And for those who are supporters, you will have access. Now, I'm not guaranteeing that I'm sending them all to everybody. You know what I'm saying? But you're going to have to request. But you do have access. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm figuring for each dollar that you spend with us. You know what I'm saying? We could go and give you a token. One of those tokens, right? You know what I'm saying? And you'll be able to get a crew, enough of those, so that when you order stuff from us, you could just use your tokens. That's the goal. You know what I'm saying? Just use your tokens, because you invested in us and have enabled us to do some stuff. You know what I'm saying? You trusted in the system. You believe in the system. You use the system. You know what I'm saying? Also, we want to give people access to being able to help our membership, because individuals need to earn a certain amount of tokens, tribal tokens, before they're able to be promoted, right? They need to be able to drop 1,000 tokens before they are able to move to the next level, right? You know what I'm saying? And as we get more advanced and better at what we're doing, of course that number's gonna go up, right? But elders in the communities that are not scared of learning will be able to plug into the system. You know what I'm saying? purchase tokens, you know what I'm saying, or earn tokens in some form or fashion, and then they'll be able to, like, you know, like, for people in Giamme that need the tokens, you know what I'm saying, you need some stuff done, you can use the tokens, and, you know, you could drop, break off some cash, but you can use the tokens as well, or both, your choice, but you will be helping them move toward what they need to do. You know what I'm saying? As far as Giamme, because Giamme has a ranking system. My ranking Bs are broke, so my daughter's fixing them, right? You know what I'm saying? Even you're going to even better get your rank Bs with that. But anyway, I digress. But anyway, we want you to communicate with us. You can send us your list of your ancestors, and that's cool. Now, another way that you can reach us is going to GiammeJourney.com on your laptop or your desktop. It don't work that well on a phone. I might work on a tablet. But on the right-hand side, you will have a little box where you can enter your email address where it say follow the journey or join the journey, blah, blah, blah. Put your email address in there. You'll get on our email list. Once you are on our email list, we will be able to correspond. We will be able to correspond and communicate. You know what I'm saying? And in that, we'll be able to grow together. All right? And then you can add your ancestors to the list. Now, I did all that stalling so that I could upload my stuff and send out my my thing to on Telegram. Let me go and add Assad. He could be mad at me later. And family, any of the groups that I have you at, if you do not want to be a part of it, please, please let me know. Okay? Hold on. I hope I ain't sending this to the wrong thing. What's this? Giamme to all. I did all that to the wrong thing. My niece is going to kill me. Lord have mercy. Poor girl, she getting all my stuff. I don't want to send it to Giamme Talk. I want to send it here. Boom. There we go. All right. There we go. And then, also, I want to throw that gift up. Boom. Join the tribe. All right, let's get this toast up and popping. Let's see. Let's see. All right. I go back through. Throw him on there. Throw him in there. And boom. Let's do that. All right. Added two more people. All right. So let's do this toast. I know you're like, brother, I tell you what's wrong, man. You're kind of off. No, I'm not off. I'm just cool. But anyway, here we go. So we're lifting up our glass to the Creator by whatever name you choose to call it, Creator. You know we already did this earlier this morning, but there ain't nothing like throwing a little spice onto the dish, right? So we raise up our Creator. We want it to be in front of our mind. We lift it up by whatever name you choose to call it, Creator. We lift up our glass and we say the word of power, Ashe. Now, family, we lift up our ancestors. Y'all already know how we do it here. We lift up our ancestors every morning. We lifted them up. We say their names earlier. And we lift them up again right now. We lift them up. We say Ashe. Right now, we get into the present moment. Right now, we are on Ujamaa, family. I ask each and every last one of you to open up your reticular formation and seek out Ujamaa. Ujamaa is real. It's out there. I want you to learn how to use it. I want you to learn how to guide it. I want you to build upon Ujamaa. I want you to use it in your presentation. I want you to write it in your report. I want you to put it in your paper. I want you to use it in a presentation. I want you to talk about your culture. I want you to bring it up in a conversation. We have to start living and breathing our culture. Right? Because this is going to be, if the shit hit the fan, or even if the shit don't hit the fan, for us to move forward, we are going to have to embrace who we are. No longer can we act like we somebody else, because we see what happens when we act as if we're somebody else when the shit hits the fan for them. They let you know clearly and squarely that you do not belong. So we're trying to create a place that we belong. We're creating our own space. We're moving people out the way. You know what I'm saying? We're creating our own space, and we're using our time wisely, and we're building. So, family, we want to recognize Ujamaa. For all those who don't speak the language, Ujamaa means cooperative economics. Reciprocity is the Maotic principle for the day. Gratitude is what we teach the young people from the Millennium 7. Green is the color, as you can see by my shirt. I did make it easier. Now, I didn't. You can go to merch.gnj.media, and I made it easier because it's a little bit more mixed. I'm still trying to figure out the system so that I can see how to group stuff together. It got to be some way I could do all that where I'm able to group stuff together, and I'm going to work it out, family. Believe me, I'm going to work it out. But I looked at it, and I couldn't quite figure it out. But... So check that out. Dig that, right? So you go to merch.gnj.media. Polarity is the Hermetic principle of the day. Male name for the day is Yao. Female name is Ya. All right? So we lift up our glass, and we salute this present moment, the power in this moment. We take responsibility for what's popping off in this moment, and we say the words of power. Come on now. Say it with me. Ashe. Now we're going to lift up our children, our children's children, onto infinity. We lift up our glass, we salute, and we say, Ashe. Now I want to do something for the day. I want to raise my glass up, send out that healing energy, because this I'm at the peak right now, right? At least in the 7-day cycle, I'm at the peak. And I want to send out this energy to Brother Kwesi and also to Elder Aziza and Elder Tony. I want to send out this energy and this blessing out to them. Those of you that know them, you know what I'm saying? Focus some energy and send some of that blessed energy out to them in this moment. We lift up our glass. And I grab my mythic phoenix egg. You got, can't be scared to create your own myths. We got a phoenix egg. Bainu dropped this off for us. He told us we are the custodians. He said it can hatch any time between now and 10,000 years. All right. So somebody has to be manning and be in place to make sure that the phoenix egg, when it does hatch, we are able to receive it. All right. We lift up our glass. We salute. We say, Ashe. 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 Ooh, sound like something breaking there. All right. So, family, y'all going, I was about to drink. Y'all go and have a great, fantabulous, great and fantabulous day. All right, I am up and I am out.
Mr. Deity. Thank you.
Alright, peace out, family. Y'all go out and conquer the day. Yes, I will. Peace.
Shop Mattress Firm's year-end sale and put an end to junk sleep. Save up to $500 when you get a king bed for the price of a queen or a queen for a twin. Plus, get a free adjustable base with qualifying Sealy purchase up to a $499 value. Or shop top-selling brands and get up to 50% off select mattresses, like Sealy Twin Mattresses starting at $224.99 or Serta Twin Mattresses at $349.99. And shop with confidence thanks to our low price guarantee. Only at Mattress Firm. Restrictions apply. See store for details.